Forget about sell in May and go away, right? Stocks surging this month. The major averages all on track for solid gains led by tech and smaller companies. Some good news there. But will these gains really go away if Democrats get their way? A bill just introduced aimed at repealing the GOP tax cuts. Should investors be worried about it? Let's ask market watchers Melissa Armo, Dan Geltrude, and Gary B. Smith. Great to see y'all. Gary, starting with you. I mean, my goodness, if you get no tax cuts or if they go away, what happens, you know, to all those people who started spending a little bit more and feeling a little bit more optimistic about their future because they had a few more bucks in their pocket each week?
Exactly, Trish. It's going to be Obama 2.0. We just went through, previous to Trump, 8 years of what I call the economic malaise. There was no incentive out there. Because of all the regulations and the government spending, everything ground to a halt. Mm-hmm. People weren't optimistic. All that changed when Trump came into office, not only cutting the regulation, but as we're talking about right here, cutting the taxes. It gave people hope out there, and now optimism's almost at an all-time high. You take those tax cuts back and you say, hey, we're the big government. We'll spend your money as we see fit. We're right back into that malaise again.
See, I think politically speaking, it's not the smartest thing to do, Melissa, only in that, you know, I don't care who you talk to. Most Americans would tell you, you know, they work pretty hard and they like to keep most of what they make.
Yeah, I have no idea why the Democrats are doing this. First of all, the tax law just passed 5 months ago, so it doesn't make any sense to even think about repealing it. But then again, they wanted to impeach Trump the day after he was elected, so I don't understand what they're doing. But the market would not have a positive reaction to any change in this. The market has had a positive reaction since the tax plan was passed, and the market has rallied. We've had a strong rally this year in 2018, and I expect it to continue, hopefully, into 2019.
So, Dan, what does that tell you about 2018? And, you know, if the Democrats are able to claim more seats than the current polls predict, what happens to the market? What happens to taxes?
I think it would be bad business for the Democrats to gain the majority, and the first thing they do is to say, listen, we got to get rid of tax cuts. It's very, very simple. Raising taxes, bad. Tax cuts, good. So I think that's basic math. Everybody understands. If the Democrats go in a different direction, I think they're going to have a lot of problems.
Yeah, you know, actually, Steve Forbes gave my kids, he met him in the green room, that kind of lesson. And when he left them, he said, so remember, taxes, higher taxes, good or bad? And they were like, bad, Mr. Forbes, definitely bad. But that's the reality, right? I mean, we need this stimulus for the economy. At the same time, though, Gary, I understand when people say they're a little concerned that, you know, we're spending more than we have, and we better get something. We better get some GDP growth out of this plan to lower taxes. And do you think we'll get it?
Well, you know, I hope so, but here's the kind of that straw man fallacy in that argument. It's not the government's responsibility to manage the economy. They're like I think of the government like your condo board, but make the building safe. You know, make sure, adjudicate disputes, and then get out of the way. The condo board doesn't say, you know what, you're not earning enough, you should earn more, let's redistribute the income. That's not the job of the government. The job of the government is to build highways, provide for our national defense, be the judicial court, the Supreme Court, and that's it. They keep on taking more and more responsibility, which means, look, we need your money to spend, again, like I said, what we see fit. That's not the government's job. Let the people have their money. The economy is going to go up and down. Stay out of it.
And then, Melissa, don't forget, I mean, what does that do to our competitiveness, right, as a nation? And we got the highest tax rates in the world.
That's right. They wanted this new plan that came out that they're going to try to do something with. I don't know. Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer want to do something where they increase now the corporate tax rates. They just decreased them. And you, think about this. They've already given some of that money in bonuses. What are they going to do if they change it? That would be horrible. The market would have a terrible reaction if they change anything with that. And remember, maybe the tax plan has some tweaking to do. We don't know, but it's not these big things. And remember this, we haven't even gone a full tax season. No one has filed. No individual has filed. No corporation has filed yet. You've got to give it at least a year.
It takes a little time, you know.
Yeah.
It's got to work its way
exactly.
Through the economy. And as Dan and Steve Forbes say, higher taxes bad. Lower taxes, good. That's the lesson of the day. Thank you so much. It's great to see you guys. Happy Memorial Day.
Thank you.
All right, you want your teenager working out and out of the house? You might want to take that phone out of their hands. My work. More next.